Am I okay? I thought I got over my cold, but I guess not. There has been a lot of discussion throughout the comments recently on the fact that I am 16, which has surprised a lot of people, I guess. I think that's funny. But where am I going with this? Well, I'll tell you. For my 16th birthday, I got a... Oh, God damn it. I got a 3D printer. These things are so underrated, it's insane. I can print whatever I want here. You know what? Here, let me do a little bit of a demo. One thing I 3D printed is this. I found this model online of just a generic furry head, and I did some editing to it, and then I added this text, and then I wrote on it Fluffy Boy. I don't know. I thought that was funny, and that was a Creative Commons model, so I am allowed to do that. In fact, let me pull up the person who made the original one. This is what I started out with. I had to add pupils and stuff, but yeah, very interesting. Come on now. It'd literally be faster for me to manually focus this. I found this model online, and it's a phone stand, believe it or not. It looks like an octopus tentacle, and you put your phone in there, which I thought was really cool. Earlier on, I tried to print some of those other heads, but they failed. I printed them a lot smaller, so now I have two failed ones just sitting around. And I also printed this lens hood, but it didn't fit very well, and I ended up just designing my own lens hood that is on the camera I am shooting with right now. My hand is on the lens hood, and I'm not touching the lens. Isn't that super fancy? This thing right here is a cornucopia of injury, okay? I've burned myself at least 5 times. Of course, that's my fault, but I got my finger caught in here, and it actually cut off my finger, believe it or not, right there. I'm kidding, not really. Didn't really cut off my finger. It just hurt a lot though. But the mind wanders. The mind wanders. On this website that I use for 3D printing models, which is called Thingiverse, I think. Thingiverse, whatever. I have all sorts of 3D models you can just print for free. And there's this whole group on there dedicated to fursuit head bases, which I was like, hey there. You're an all-star. You know, typically, you would get some sort of styrofoam thing, and obviously that has to be sculpted, so it typically costs a lot of money. This would be so much cheaper. Assuming you have a 3D printer already, it probably wouldn't be cost effective to buy a 3D printer specifically for this purpose. So I figured I could make a video on this subject. I found this one. I like it because it reminds me of Crash a little bit because of the nose. I found this one, which was designed by the same person the other one was designed by, and I like this one. It reminds me of Rainy for some reason, but I don't know why exactly. What about it? Maybe it's the eyebrows. I don't know. That doesn't make any sense. I am going to print miniature versions of both of them, because if I was gonna print the complete thing, it would take hours, like several days to print. Without any further ado, I guess I'm gonna print them out and see what happens. Go printer, go! Oh God, I don't wanna get sued. Please don't sue me, Stereo Killers. I'm your favorite fan. I'm your best fan. Forget it. Forgot I even said anything. Just got out of the printer. Actually, not really. It got out of the printer like a day ago, but I've been busy. Now, as you can see, I printed this to like a tiny scale of what it would actually come out to be. This is supposed to be the size of your head. So as you can imagine, it didn't take as long as it normally would have. Right now, it doesn't look like much, but when you start to piece it together, you get this and you put it like that, and you're like, oh, something's happening. And then this is the jaw, which I thought was incredibly small, but I realized there's holes here, and you're supposed to put wire through there, I think, to get the jaw to move, because the guy who modeled this was very creative in that it appears to be able to be used as an animatronic base as well, which I think is extremely interesting. Technologicify it a little bit. You're already 3D printing it, so I'm not sure if you can technologify it anymore, but I guess he's proved me wrong. Basically, what I'm gonna do now is clean up all the supports that were on here, sand it, make it look good for the camera, and glue it together and see how it turns out. And then, I think I'm gonna print some others? I mean, I will talk momentarily. So, I went ahead and I glued this together, and now you can sort of see there's, once it focuses here, There's a rather severe underbite, mostly because I tried to do the wire connection thing, and it just didn't work very well. Was that a flash? What happened? It mostly just didn't work very well, so I decided the best course of action would just be to glue it like that. And I mean, you know what? If I actually printed it to the right scale, you know, put a little bit more effort into it, I think it would turn out great. It's a really nicely made model, so kudos to the guy who made that. I cannot pronounce their name, but showed their account earlier. Anyways, I decided that I would try to print more models versus just like one really large one, mostly because I'm not going to be using them, and I don't think that's really what the video is about. It's more about like, how can you apply a 3D printer to furry. Let's take a look at this. This is real nice. I tried to print out another one of these head bases and it failed. My favorite part about this is that it's just like, it's so brittle. It's because I printed it too thin. It's my fault, not the printer. But I mean, come on, it looks like a, I don't know, like some sort of city with like, that's been broken down, like some sort of ruins or something. I don't know. As you can hear, the 3D printer is very loud, so I apologize for that. Anyways, another thing I found online was this angel dragon head, which is apparently a 3D scan of an actual suit head. And I went ahead and loaded that up, and as you can see here, I mean, there's a little bit of artifacting right there. And that's just because it's a 3D scan, which means I'm assuming they made it out of pictures. So there's all sorts of ways artifacting can happen, but I am very impressed with how this model looks. So much so that I decided to print it out. Now, once again, my scale's a little bit off because it's really tiny. That's so small. Also, I was thinking to myself, I said, hey, you know, the acrylic claws you can buy, high quality paws, I guess you could say. Look, point is, they're pretty expensive, or at least they're more expensive than 3D printing it. So I'm also 3D printing a claw right now, so we can try that soon. And I could really like clean up my room a little bit. There's all this stuff in the background. What is this? What are those pictures of? I don't know. None of this stuff is mine. This over here is all mine. All of this stuff, I don't know what that is, so don't mind that. Let's focus a little bit. Let's get some focus power. And, yeah, basically, I have to go on a hike now for the next 2 days in the wilderness. So I will talk to you soon, and I will get back, and I will see what those look like, and I'll have some final thoughts, and I can edit this video and post it, and hopefully I'm not late. So I'll talk to you guys soon. Oh my God. It was only like 12 miles, but man, my legs hurt like hell. I'm not very athletic if you haven't figured that out yet. Anyways, where are we? Oh, right. Okay, so this is what came out of the printer. I'm kidding, that's just the support material. I pranked you hardcore. Oh my God. Remember I said something about not being athletic? Anyways, this is what actually came out of the printer. That's the claw. And then we have, drum roll please, the scan of that head from earlier. So, basically, what is my point here? What are my closing thoughts? This turned out great. Of course, it's not very high resolution because of how small the print had to be. So I could get this video out relatively on time, but as you can see, it's very solid, and the 3D scan itself was actually very high quality. This would make like you could scale this up to like a foot long, and it would make a really nice little desktop thing. I don't know. This turned out fantastic. This was totally, well, I talk about this like I came up with the idea, but obviously I didn't. My train of thought though was totally going on the right track, because honey, there's a little bit of misprinting up at the top there, as you can see. That's just because the model wasn't stable as it was printing, so it got a little bit wobbly. I mean, and this is fresh out of the printer. If I just sanded that down a little bit, that would turn out amazing. And it's like a few cents of plastic. Imagine painting it black and putting it in to replace these. Call back to the pause video, right? Totally a great solution for that. That being said, is it worth buying a 3D printer for the express purpose to 3D print a fursuit head base, which is, that's what I, my main intention of making this video, that's the main question I wanted to answer. I don't think it makes a lot of sense to buy a printer for that express purpose, considering it costs hundreds of dollars and it would probably be easier to just get a foam case, a foam base. Foam case, oh my god, it's late, I'm tired. It would probably be easier to get a foam base and then work with that. Granted, you could also buy one of these, like this model, fully printed online for probably a lot cheaper than a foam hand sculpted base. And then you could always like do some sort of additive thing where you put on some sort of foam material in places where you want the like certain parts of it to be more structured or whatever, you know, like you could. Okay, another great purpose for this would be if you were making like a sculpture, you could use this as the base and put clay on top of it, and that would be amazing. Wow, I didn't even think about that. All that being said, should you buy a 3D printer for this purpose? Probably not. It doesn't make a lot of sense. Should you use 3D printed parts though? Totally. The models are out there, free to use, anybody can, you know. It's, the plastic's cheap, it's strong, it's tough, it stands up really well. If I would have spent the time to just print all the separate pieces and glue them together, I'm sure I could have made a very realistic, very practical, cheap head base. With the only thing I would really have to do that is put in the time and the plastic, which probably would be pretty cheap amount of plastic depending on how thick you want the final print to be. God, I gotta sleep and I gotta try to get this video out. So let's see here. I just hit 5,000 subscribers, which is amazing. Thank you. I know there's a lot of new people here around because of that paw video. So seriously, I welcome you. Thanks for staying along for the ride. I was thinking about giving away one of these for 5,000 subscribers. I thought that would be fun. But I know we just did the paw giveaway thing and my like shipping budget for shipping out that type of thing is pretty low at this point. So if a lot of you guys want me to do that, just give away one of those things, I think I will. I just want to make sure people actually want it, so I'm not like just printing it and giving it away for no reason. Along sort of those lines, for 5,000, I have this really amazing t-shirt in the works. I haven't done really anything except request it, but basically Glitchmutt is drawing this really amazing thing. I'm going to slap it on a t-shirt and sell it for probably about $15-ish, depending on the type of shirt you get. And all profits from it is going directly to Glitchmutt, the artist who drew it. So I am not gonna receive anything from that. You buy the shirt, you support the artist who put the drawing on the shirt. I think that's really fair. So check out my merch store if you're interested in that. It's going to be out sometime soon. I'll probably talk about it in a future video when it actually does come out. Also, I have a Patreon. I'm not sure if you guys forgotten about that. I have the Hall of Supporters over there. If you want to, any penny count. I don't think you can donate pennies on Patreon, but any dollar count, seriously. I take it all, put it directly into making better videos for you guys. So, thanks for watching. Love you. Talk to you later. I really need to work on how I end these videos. This sucks. How's this for an ending? I'm sort of disturbed by this. My name is Telephone. Ooh.